Hey folks, Jonathan again, on our way to a tow. It's Wednesday morning, and I did get to sleep at almost 7 o'clock anyway. But got a Ford Super Duty. I love the F-250, F-350, but another 6.0 truck to go tow. And we've towed our share of these things, but I'm in the homemade rollback. Does a lot better with them trucks, but anyway, we'll go grab it and get it towed, and we'll see what the day brings us. Okay, we got this one loaded up. It turned out to be a 7.3 truck. So usually when we get a tow for a Ford Super Duty, you know, we assume it's either a 6.0 or a 6.4, usually a 6.0, but this one just happened to be a 7.3. So, anyway, we'll get this thing to the garage and we'll see what comes in. Okay, so I'm on the way back from the Ford truck tow and I got a highway patrol call. I've got to stop by the house, which is actually on the way, and swap the record. And it looks like it's going to be on Nursery Road, which is just about washed out in one spot. So I'm hoping I'm not going to have to go in the water. And they actually requested me to bring a record, so Highway Patrol, if they do that, then chances are it's in a really bad spot. It's a Ford Mustang, that's about all I know. So take the camera with us and see what we can do. All right. Well, I was told that nursery's mostly dry, there's not much water left, so I don't know, maybe this is over an embankment or something. Find out here shortly.
get it up out and not have to worry about it flipping over. We're gonna get it unhooked and get to the front of it. Okay, I came just from around the corner from where I was. I left this thing, I actually let it run. That's why I rolled the windows down, the door locked on me. I left it running, and this thing's got 4,871 miles on it. We're gonna put her back in park and shut it off. Now we're gonna let it down and go around to the back of it. Now the reason I left it running is because I towed it in neutral. Now, I only came about a little over a quarter of a mile, but I stayed at about 30 mile an hour too, so I don't take chances on that. Running in neutral, then you know the pump, everything's still getting fluid to it, so that won't hurt it a bit. And there's no damage on radiator or anything like that, but we're gonna go ahead and drop it right here and get turned around and get it hooked up from the back. Okay, we got the Mustang unloaded. I'm hoping that I got all that video. I don't know, we'll see what happens, but we've only got about 17 minutes left on this card. So I've got to kind of rush this one. This is going to be a service truck for a plumbing company. I guess they pulled off the road. He said he wanted to get out of the truck and just about stepped on a copperhead and then moved the truck and got stuck. So they said they've already had two tractors and a couple of four-wheel drive trucks try to pull them out. They couldn't get them out, so we're going to go get him out. All right. Shouldn't be any issue.
Well, I hope it'll be good. I got some good tail running around the frame over here.
Okay. All right, we'll hook to it till we're done.
Loaded pretty heavy and he was in there pretty deep, but not a problem. We pulled him on out. I was worried about his license plates on the front. He kept saying don't worry about him, he, you know, rip them off, and I didn't want to do that, so I kept letting off enough to get it to where it wouldn't drag him across. So, I hate tearing stuff up, but anyway, he's out, we're good to go. Right.
Okay folks, we're back from the winch out on the service truck there, and wanted to show you the Mustang here. You know, where that thing was a really bad spot, and you know, took the extra time and precautions to not tear anything up. And as you can see, no damage whatsoever anywhere on the back side of this car. And I'm gonna, well, I've already done it, I guess. Put little titles in there on the video to show the people why I done this particular recovery the way that I've done it. Made the front damage was what was already there. Brand new car. But as you can see, it's definitely not total. And, you know, the only damage is really bumper. There's a little damage on the hood. Well, here, and then a lot of scratches where he went through the trees, but you know, it was a pretty bad spot where he was. You know, the car could have flipped over pretty easy. Camera never shows the actual angles and stuff that you're dealing with. You know, it was steep. So you know, besides a good wash job and some front end work, you know, this car is ready to go. 4,000 miles, he hadn't made his first payment. So, really, you know, no issues, no problems. And that's, you know, that's the way you need to be on all calls. It don't matter, you know, now if it's a burnt or tore all two pieces, you know, there's sometimes, you know, there's nothing you can do. And, you know, if one's rolled over and you roll it back over on the opposite side and it breaks the mirror off or the window, you know, it's just, it is what it is. But when it's something that, you know, believe it or not, where it was, it should have been a total loss. But, you know, there's no reason to tear it up getting it out. So, anyway, we'll see what happens. It's about lunchtime now, so this is just this morning's work. All right. Thank you.